I'm about to show you a video of Tesla Model Y, how it reacts on autopilot when a big truck suddenly swerves into the left lane. And today, Tesla CEO Elon Musk also updated on the status of Tesla's full self-driving software and said Tesla is now working on, quote, final piece of the FSD AI puzzle, explaining what that final piece is. Welcome back, everyone. This is Armen Haryan from TorqueNews.com. If you are here first time, please take a moment and subscribe to our channel for daily Tesla and electric vehicle news, and ring the bell so you don't miss my next coverage. Tesla blogger Ray for Tesla on Twitter, or maybe I should call it X now, on X, shared this video from Chinese sources while with the following writing. Ray says, "We need to take driving seriously and pay attention to traffic all the time, no matter what vehicles we drive. However, in absolute emergency scenarios, Tesla Autopilot may give you an edge, as demonstrated in this video." This Model Y owner was driving at around 100 kilometers while AP autopilot was activated. 100 kilometers is equal to 65 or so miles. All of a sudden, the big truck swerved into his lane. At that brief moment, his eyes were off the road, searching for music for his kids. Now, apparently, that's what the Chinese sources says. And he continues saying, by the time he realized it, AEB had already kicked in my Model Y, quickly moved to the adjacent lane. Owner was thankful Tesla saved him. God saved him through this autopilot and his kids. That was a quote. If you had situations where Tesla AP or FSD, autopilot or full self-driving, have reacted in a similar way, please, friends, let me know in the comment section below. I would like to hear from you. But one Twitter user named John doubted this was the autopilot, and I want to quote his comment and ask your opinion as to what you think is the autopilot or human interaction. John writes the following on former Twitter, current X. He says, "I've had Tesla AP autopilot pull me over when the lane ended while I was looking down, and it surprised me that it actually did it. But that's not AP pulling the person over in this video. That's the person doing. You can tell by how the car moves. It's jerky, as if a person is yanking the wheel." So that was the end from John, quote. So what do you think, friends? Do you think this is AP or human interaction? In any case, thank God everything ended well in this situation, and please drive carefully. In the meantime, Tesla CEO Elon Musk yesterday said Tesla is now working on the final piece of the full self-driving AI puzzle, and apparently that is vehicle control. Despite his best efforts to stop making predictions about self-driving, the CEO of Tesla has recently still predicted that Tesla would achieve full autonomy by the end of the year. Remember, that was a few weeks ago. For many of us who use Tesla FSD beta regularly, it is hard to imagine that Tesla can make the jump from the current state of the level, current state, which is officially level 2, to a level 4 or level 5 autonomy, where the automaker would take responsibility for the system and enable drivers to use it without monitoring in just a few months. But that's what Elon Musk is suggesting, pending regulatory approval, obviously. On Twitter, the CEO yesterday said that Tesla is now working on the final piece, that's quote, final piece of the Tesla FSD AI puzzle. He says it is, quote, vehicle control. Vehicle control is the final piece of the Tesla FSD AI puzzle, Musk said, that will drop less than 300,000 lines of C++ control code by approximately 2 orders of magnitude. I don't know what 2 orders of magnitude is. Maybe this is coding or programming cool language. I don't know. If you guys know, let me know in the comment section below. Now, it sounds like Tesla plans to more heavily rely on neural nets for vehicle control rather than direct coded instructions. The CEO added that Tesla is currently training these neural nets, and that training compute is the limitation at this point. "It is training as I write this," he said. "Our progress is currently training compute constrained, not engineer constrained." Wow. Musk has been talking a lot lately about the Tesla has been securing as much compute power from NVIDIA as possible, on top of deploying its own Dojo supercomputer program at the same time. As you know, I'm certainly not the most optimistic person in the past have been when it comes to full self-driving, because it takes time, because there are lots of regulatory issues. But the last of my optimism has been linked to Tesla's Dojo program and the potential to accelerate the rate of improvement of the system. This is also noted in Electric on its take, which he says, I haven't been impressed with over the last few 2 years. Tesla has started to deploy the supercomputer this month, and it could potentially accelerate the training of Tesla's many neural nets powered full self-driving. Obviously, this could just be hopeful thinking, and there could be bigger underlying problems, but we'll see. We'll continue looking into this. Let me know your thoughts, friends, on this. What do you think about the advance and progress of Tesla's full self-driving? This is Armen Haryan from TorqueNews.com. Let's move on to our next story.
Good morning, everyone. Tesla blogger on Twitter, Gregor Truck, has a new video that shows a beautiful Cybertruck walk around at Tesla Gigafactory, Texas. This was actually done yesterday, and as you're seeing, this is the release candidate walk around at Giga Texas. While you're watching this video and seeing this walk around, I want to show you something very important that Monroe and Associates said about Cybertruck. Experts from Monroe and Associates state reasons why the Tesla Cybertruck could weigh less than Rivian R1T Hummer EV and their teardown experts show. That means Tesla Cybertruck is going to be lighter and hopefully have a much better range when the official numbers come. So in a new Monroe Live episode, teardown specialist Sandy Monroe and Corey Stubbs speculate about the Tesla Cybertruck based on factory images, spy shots, and their prior experience with Model 3 and Model Y teardowns. One of their predictions is that the Tesla Cybertruck electric pickup truck might weigh less than the Rivian R1T and General Motors Hummer EV. The experts reason that the Cybertruck's multiple giga castings, including a single piece front underbody giga casting and two giga castings in the side and the rear, could save more weight compared to the other electric trucks that I just mentioned. The Tesla appears to have a unibody construction, while the Cybertruck appears to have a unibody construction, while the Hummer and Rivian have a ladder frame chassis, which generally weigh more. You have no frame, no mating interfaces. You also have an efficient structural battery pack, said Steuben in that video. I will have the link of the video in the description of this video, friends, as well as the reference to this video that you're watching. The Cybertruck could weigh no less than 6,000 pounds for tax purposes. He added the R1T from Rivian has a gross vehicle weight rating of 8,532 pounds, while the Hummer reportedly tips scales at over 9,000 pounds. They say that the Tesla could be comparatively lighter than these other electric pickup trucks. To classify as a light-duty truck, a vehicle has to be more than 6,001 pounds, but not exceed 10,000 pounds as per the Federal Highway Administration. Although EPA's classifications differ and categorize the Rivian as a heavy-duty truck. Another prediction is of Cybertruck's incredible structural strength. The front crash structure, including the A and B pillars, appear remarkably stiff and are possibly made from boron steel at hot stampede steel, said Monroe. Honestly, I don't know what boron steel is and hot stampede steel is, but I assume they are very durable materials, durable type of steel, of course. In other words, Tesla could use ultra-high strength steel in critical areas to comply with safety regulations. The two experts made the analysis based on the picture that you have been seeing, the body in black, which is the structure beneath the skin. This thing, the A and B pillars, I have a report about A and B pillars in the past from in this Torque News YouTube channel, friends. You can check that out. So this thing, the A and B pillars, is going to be bulletproof. There is no way that anybody is going to crash and have an issue, predicted Monroe. So what do you think about this walk around and the way of the side?
Cybertruck. Let me know your thoughts, friends, in the comment section below. Let's talk about this, and let me know if you have heard anything from Tesla about your Cybertruck order, if you have pre-ordered one. This is Armin Harayan. God bless you, everyone. Please subscribe to this channel for more news. Ring the bell and continue this participating in discussions. And if you would like, please support us, sending us super thanks and or buying products from my product list. God bless you, and see you soon in our next report.